Hello student, this is our sixth video for class 6, chapter 1, Introduction to Chemistry. We have learned lot of things in chemistry, how it is useful in our clothing, in our food, in our preservation of food, in our fertilizers, in our clothing and so on. Today we have to learn about chemistry in medicine. How chemistry is helping in medicine. We are using the medicine earlier also. But how we are using? We are using to prevent disease which we extract from plants and animals. Or even we are not able to cure our disease properly, right? So what happened? The chemistry has given a lot many things in medicines. So that today we have to learn. You can see in the screen that I have kept some of the medicine for you, so that you can see. You must be having in your home. So read it very carefully, back side, front side, what is the name of it? It is used for what purpose? Like this, I will show you. As you are seeing, it is one of the medicine which is used to reduce swelling and it relieves pain. So it is given by the chemistry. It is a development of chemistry, so that it is available in the chemical form, and that is very helpful to us, right? In the same way, the second which I have kept for you, it is also one of the medicine. Its name is whatever it is written, you can see, Atharax. It is also used in the anti-itch lotion. It is known as anti-itch lotion, which can it be utilized, and so on. Here one more medicine I have kept for you, right? You can see the back side of it and all, whichever you are having. Just I have seen, kept here to show you that how medicines look like and what is the use of it, how it is categorized, that we will study, right? So let's start. We have to start chemistry in medicine. This is our sixth video, and different branches are there, different types are there, right? The medicines are categorized in different types. Like it is categorized in antibiotic, in analgesics, in antipyretic, in antiseptic, and antacids, and many more. But we have to learn these things, like antibiotic, analgesics. Speak with me, okay? So that you should also able to understand what is this. Antipyretic, antiseptics, antacids. Now in the short, I am going to explain this. What is this? Like this, antibiotic. Antibiotic is one of the category of medicine. Nowadays it is given to everybody. Like suppose, because this is a case in the human being, that when he is suffering with a fever, very less people can get cured by taking only the medicine, right? Otherwise it will be carrying on till you will take an antibiotic, and then only it will be cured. Now what is antibiotic? Actually, antibiotic is made from the microorganism. Microorganism, perhaps you have learned in biology. I cannot explain in this video, but I can tell you what is antibiotic, right? So antibiotic is produced by various species of microorganism. Microorganism, right? Now what the microorganisms do? They kill the bacteria. They kill the bacteria. Antibiotic kill the bacteria which is causing disease in your body, right? So antibiotic is made from microorganism. What is its use? It kill the bacteria which cure disease in your body, राइट. सो वन ऑफ द एंटीबायोटिक मोस्ट पॉपुलर एंटीबायोटिक नेम इज पेनिसिलिन. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस ऑल्सो इन द शॉर्ट आई हैव रिटन. यू कैन टेक अ प्रिंट स्क्रीन ऑफ इट और स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ इट और यू कैन राइट इट डाउन इन योर केमिस्ट्री नोटबुक. राइट. सो दिस इज एंटीबायोटिक. नाउ एनर्जिक्स. वॉट इज एनर्जिक्स? एज आई हैव शोन यू दिस वन, दिस वन. राइट. सो दिस इज एनर्जिक्स. एनर्जिक्स इज एक्चुअली वन टाइप ऑफ मेडिसिन, कैटेगरी ऑफ मेडिसिन यू कैन से, विच हेल्प टू रिड्यूस पेन, विच हेल्प टू रिड्यूस पेन. इट इज इन द कॉमन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जिक्स विच यू कैन फाइंड इन द मार्केट इज एस्पिरिन एंड पैरासिटामोल. आई होप पैरासिटामोल यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दिस नेम, पैरासिटामोल. राइट. एस्पिरिन ऑल्सो. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज एंटीपायरेटिक. एंटीपायरेटिक, वॉट इज एंटीपायरेटिक? एंटीपायरेटिक इज वन ऑफ द केमिकल सबस्टेंस. इट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स टू रिड्यूस बॉडी टेम्परेचर वेन यू हैव द फीवर एंड ऑल. देन पैरासिटामोल. पैरासिटामोल इज यूज एज एनर्जिक्स ऑल्सो एंड एंटीपायरेटिक्स ऑल्सो. एनर्जिक्स वेन यू हैव द बॉडी पेन, वेन यू हैव द पेन इन एनी पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी. एंड इट इज ऑल्सो यूज वेन यू हैव अ हाई टेम्परेचर, देन दैट टाइम ऑल्सो यू कैन टेक पैरासिटामोल. दीज आर द नेम ऑफ द मेडिसिन विच आर कॉमन. राइट. मेनी मेनी मोर मेडिसिन आर देयर बट विच आर वेरी वेरी कॉमन एंड वी आर यूजिंग. दिस इज अ टाइप ऑफ द कैटेगरी ऑफ द मेडिसिन एंड दीज आर द कॉमन मेडिसिन विच वी आर यूजिंग. राइट. नेक्स्ट इज एंटीसेप्टिक. बोरोप्लस यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड. टर्मरिक, नीम. टर्मरिक एंड नीम, दीज आर द वॉट यू कैन से, दीज आर द नेचुरल एंटीसेप्टिक. टर्मरिक एंड नीम आर द नेचुरल एंटीसेप्टिक. देन बोरोप्लस, देर ऑल्सो केमिकल्स आर यूज एंड वी आर लर्निंग केमिस्ट्री इन मेडिसिन, हाउ द केमिस्ट्री हैज हेल्प्ड. देन नेक्स्ट इज एंटाएसिड. वेन यू हैव द गैस, वेन यू हैव ईटन समथिंग ऑयली स्पाइसी फूड, देन यू हैव द गैस. सो वाई इट हैपन्स? दिस हैपन्स बिकॉज ऑफ द एसिड्स इज फॉर्म्ड, एसिड इज फॉर्म्ड इन योर बॉडी. सो वॉट वी टेक? वी टेक एंटाएसिड. वी टेक एंटाएसिड. सो बेस्ट वन ऑफ द कॉमन फॉर्म ऑफ एंटाएसिड इज मिल्क ऑफ मैग्नेशिया. मिल्क ऑफ मैग्नेशिया. दीज आर द कैटेगरी, दीज आर द कॉमन मेडिसिन विच वी आर यूजिंग इन आर लाइफ. सो मिल्क ऑफ मैग्नेशिया, what it do? It neutralize the acid which is formed in our stomach. It neutralized and helps us to cure that acids and we will be normal. Okay, so this is, that is all for chemistry in medicine. Now one more topic we need to cover, that is chemistry in industry. Students, I am explaining it, you have also to go through to the book which is given in your textbook. Read it very very clearly, carefully, once, twice, so that you can understand. Okay, because chemistry is chemistry, physics, bio is new for you, so it will take some time, but you can understand well. I have expectation from you. Okay student, so carry on. Let's carry on. Chemistry in industry. Chemistry in, how it is helping in chemistry in industry. I think you know how it's helping in our industry. What were industry before, when chemistry were developed, how we are using industry, and what is the situation of the industry today. You are aware of it, right? But till then we will cover one or two points so that it should clarify to you very very well. One is, so let's to we will cover two topic, plaster of Paris and glass. Now plaster of Paris. Plaster of Paris short form is also given, that is POP, Plaster of Paris. Right. So what is Plaster of Paris and how it is used? So Plaster of Paris is used in surgery when you have the somebody broke his hand or leg, that time plaster, you must be hearing in a normal language, that it's a plaster.
plaster. So what is that? It is actually plaster of Paris, POP. So it also helps in medicine in the hospital, as well as it also helps in decorative purpose of the ceiling, false ceiling wall you have seen in the flat and all. You have seen the statues, made up of statues, many statues you have seen, like statues means you understood now, murti, right? Any statues. Okay, so that is also nowadays it is made up of plaster of Paris. And many, many more things. It is used in the ceiling wall. Then decorative purpose also it is being used. Okay. The next is about glass. So glass, what is glass? Glass is the same glass, right? But it's again it is categorized in different form. So in the short we can say transparent substance. Transparent substance is glass. And it is made up of what? It is made up of silicate. It is made up of silicate. So I have written some of the categories like safety glass, photochromatic glass, colored glass, and Pyrex glass. Right. So what is safety glass? And what we do with that? Safety glass we use in automobiles, in the car, in the bus, in the front. You see na? The glass. That is known as safety glass. Okay. So this is safety glass. The second is photochromatic glass. As the name specify, the spelling is wrong here. You can correct it. It's a photochromatic glass. Photochromatic glass is used in cameras. It is also used in the specs, right? So photochromatic glass. The second is colored glass. As the name specify, colored glass. So it is used for decoration. So it is used for decoration purpose. Then Pyrex glass. Pyrex glass is also one type of glass which can withstand. Withstand means which can hold very, very high temperature. And it is used in many, many useful purposes, right? Some more categories are given in your book. Student, you can go through it, right? These are the main points. And this chapter number 1, Introduction to Chemistry, is completed in this video. Whatever I have explained, please see it very, very carefully. Underline in your notebook. Sorry, underline in your book, write it, note it down in your notebook. Okay, so that you should have a proper notes. Okay, student, thank you.